it's me. Cassie AK Blue. Did some amnesia.
Don't forget. Some things must be forgotten. The shadow haunting me. I must hurry. My name is Daniel. I live in London at Mayfair. What have I done? Stop him. Focus. My name is I am Daniel.
Noises outside of here to interrupt. Yeah, no way I'm going in there. I don't even know what happens in there. But really enjoying it though.
Of August 1839. I wish I could ask how much you remember. I don't know if there'll be anything left after I consume this drink. Don't be afraid, Daniel. I can't tell you why, but know this. I choose to forget. Try to find comfort and strength in that fact. There is a purpose. You are my final effort to put things right. God willing, the name Alexander of Brandenburg still invokes bitter anger in you. If not, this will sound horrible. Go to the inner sanctum, find Alexander, and kill him. His body is old and weak, and yours, young and strong. He will be no match for you. One last thing. A shadow is following you. It's a living nightmare, breaking down reality. I have tried everything, and there is no way to fight back. You need to escape it as long as you can. Redeem us both, Daniel. Descend into the darkness where Alexander waits and murder him. Your former self, Daniel.
Just hold on, guys, for a sec.
Alexander, is it inside the castle?
In a manner of speaking, come through the lamp. You've been to the refinery, have you not?
I don't believe I have. Is it connected to the... What did you call it?
The inner sanctum. My most precious chamber, Daniel. And it lies well beyond the refinery. In fact, it lies beneath the very stone of Brennenburg.
May 1839. The unflinching African sun has continued to plague our expedition, making it impossible to dig until dusk. How Professor Herbert managed to find the location in these vast plains of nothingness remains a mystery to me. When I asked him about the tomb again, he told me about the legend of Tin Hanan, the mother of us all. An interesting story in its own right, but I can't help feeling there's more. Later that evening, we uncovered a passage beneath the dunes leading to a sand-covered stone structure. The professor was confident it was the tomb we sought and ordered the others to clear the way late into the dark, cold night. Tomorrow, I shall lead the men into the ancient structure, hoping to reach the burial chamber. No matter what the professor is keeping from me, the dig should yield something interesting to take back to London and the British Museum.
Don't mind me here. Just kind of blocking a band, someone that needs to people that need it to be. On to the next area. Because I'm actually going to light this area because this is kind of dark. Look how nice that is. Thank you. And this note is basically about William, who is a guy who is trying to help Alexander out pretty much and doing stuff for him, kind of just to help him out. Pretty much is what he does as his job. So, that's pretty natural thing for him, as I remembered in the story lore, is that he was supposed to be like someone that was like helping her, helping him, Alexander, out pretty much. Being on Alexander's team or anybody else's. So yeah, that's what he does. Pretty much that's what he does. I do have to say the atmosphere here is a pretty good one. It's more though from the game. Oh, that's nice and bright.
May 17th, 1839. My hands tremble as I write. I feel a need to document my tribulation, for I fear that my memory will fail me if I linger. Today, I took some men and ventured into the dark, ancient passage we uncovered. Our torches burned faintly in the murky air as we slowly made our way underground. The men were superstitious and fearful. They argued loudly, and I felt their strange language getting to me. I mustered my strength and yelled at them to continue down the slopes and broken steps. The crudely carved passage confused me. It looked much older than the 4th century structure we had expected. The twisting path emerged into a great antechamber. The walls were lined with statues unlike any I'd ever seen. Despite their unearthly quality, I felt a strange familiarity toward them, which haunts me still. At the far end of the chamber, a great slab of stone sealed off whatever lay ahead. I gave the order to raise it, and as I pushed through the narrow space, the heavy stone suddenly dropped, sealing me inside. I was trapped.
That sounds scary.
Giving stone wall for what seemed like an eternity, I realized it was hopeless. I was trapped. I fell to the ground, gasping for air, trying to focus. That's when I saw a faint blue shimmer. My weakened body was heavy to carry, but I managed to push myself toward the enchanting light. Closed in dark nothingness, I felt myself drawn to the mystic light. I reached out, closing it in my hand.
Here we go.
The faint glow escaped my fingers and began to spark, brightening and spirit me away, unlocking alien memories of spiraling towers, endless deserts, and impossible geometry. The next thing I can remember is the grating sound of stone being lifted, the voices of the Arabs pulling me to safety, and grasped firmly in my hands was the broken pieces of a most peculiar relic.
Swift when you activate the first one. You hear that? If it stops, you'll have to start over.
Isn't all this a bit excessive?
You...
Sorry, guys, I had to cut in with this, but... This story's about everything that happened, pretty much. All the different lore in the game.
Be too careful, Daniel.
Yes. Never be too careful. And I think it means to pull these books. That's what this is all about. Just saying. Just to tell you. crushed by a soulless head. Find my box. Perfect. That looks like a good barricade. Oh, and I have no online materials, I can't. See him for a moment, but he does go away. Oh well, you guys did get to at least see him. The snow up, but the snow is basically explaining to you what is happening, pretty much. Sorry, guys. Basically, the snow tells you what's happening to the people. Pretty much. William, what's happening to William, pretty much. just kind of basically talk about the stuff that you're going to be doing here. Pretty much. The note time of the chemical, and I think his properties and what the parties help with and do. Be interested, I'd say. If it wasn't for the thought of you, my love, I wouldn't be able to go on when I find myself doing terrible things. I take comfort in you as long as I am able and think of you and long for life. Together, I know I'm better than others. I weep for them and lust for power and without restraint, and I only carry a fair judgment and a safe return. Thank you.
dark in here.
Yes, and there's a good reason for it. But you can light the lamp now if you wish.
What's the reason
for the darkness, that is?
Stay close. Be careful not to stray.
What's the reason? Why is it so dark?
Pay attention, Dandel. It's important that you keep going straight and make sure not to stray.
It's been more than a month since my last entry. After the event inside the underground chamber in Algeria, Professor Herbert insisted I return to England. He said he didn't want to risk forfeiting the entire expedition lest I took a turn for the worse. An excessive decision, in retrospect. But I'm glad it turned out that way. I found my journal this morning in the haphazard collection of things brought home from Africa. Next to it lay the broken stone orb wrapped in cloth. I tried to assemble it, but couldn't. The pieces wouldn't fit together, as if they weren't from the same object. Could I have imagined it all? Was there ever a complete orb?
Ow. Whoops.
happy too, because technically that monster did kind of cause a little drama in my brain.
June 1839. I feel the need to continue this journal, even though it was intended for my journey to Africa. This must be something very important. I just know it. I've taken it upon myself to piece the orb back together, but it's been more difficult than one might think. The pieces are behaving strangely. They seem to change color, shape, and texture, but ever so slightly. Yesterday, I took careful measurements and notated any significant markings. Today, I confirmed my suspicions. They were changing. I was terrified and rushed off to see the finest geologist in London, Sir William Smith. I approached the subject with care, and we discussed how rocks change form. He told me about the nature of glass, how it eventually collapses on itself, like ice slowly melting over the course of centuries. Smith eased my mind a bit, but I can't escape the feeling that these shards have otherworldly properties.
Oh, that was interesting. sorry. Than the last place we just had. get to do maybe one more area. That guys, I got scared by my mom, so I got loud. I'm sorry. I'm overly scared from this game, so whoops. Sorry about that, guys. Very apologetic about that. I think it's animal experimenting that they are talking about on here. Interesting. Now our animal experiment kind of vente thing. Kind of interesting. Perfect. It has a new head now. Oh, that's fun. And on to the next area across here. So this knows about all the machine rods and what they do pretty much. Pretty cool, I have to say. Oh. area will be the guest room for today. Because there'll be a snap collecting all the stuff there. And then next time I'll do the storage and the rest of it.
I received a letter today from the Algerian governor's office disclosing the fate of Herbert's expedition. About a week after my departure, Abdullah, one of the men traveling with us, returned from the desert. He was badly injured, as if maimed by a lion. The man, the French, quickly dispatched.
I'm just gonna, like, so I'm not gonna have the Norse read, but
I'll collect July. Them. Mate, I continue his account.
Actually gonna end it right here and then we'll continue after. So I'm gonna do my end stuff here, guys, and first I'll do my teams. And this is my first team called the Savage Squad. You guys can follow and support if you're new. There's no mean or world troll and stuff, cause I know they don't like that. So my team, we have my friends Dashless Gaming, Imposter, Webex, Matthew, Nice Forte, and Famous Gamer, Kajaxi. Lucky Sna, Neil Heimer, the call rate, O'Mill 55, and Sparrow 2355. Come on, guys. Now do my team on Nightmare Crew. Sorry, this is... And this is my theme, Nightmare Crew. Of course, you guys can follow and support. Just don't mean rude, troll things. And there's Epicness, oh yeah, Royal Fruit, Architects, Ballad Bullet, Little JR4, ICQ777, Club Charles, The Storm, and High Pain Creatures. And this is my second half team, which you can also follow if you want. There's no mean or rude showing things, just be nice and kind. And there's my friend Mary, Campbell, Lay is my avatar, Thunderstorm TV, my awesome good friend Scary and Direct for You, my girlfriend Laura 6683, my awesome friend Foxmas Prime, my besties Rainbows 1963, and my sister like really good friend Princess XDR 26. And my last half of my team, which you guys can follow and support, just as I said before, no mean, rude, trolling things to them, just be nice and kind. And my third half of my team has my friend Watermelon Go and Sprayton. Sprayton's the one I meant. On. No, mine worked. I'll do my emotes here. All my tears, so... you guys can see them. In my tier 1, we have my... hold on, we are missing one. Really? Sorry, guys. Oh my goodness. Sorry about that. In my tier 1, we have my Gypsy Sub Hype. My... Gif Hype, my Lurky Snowy, which is a cute little chicken with Lurk on its heart with snow. Only one I'm afraid, pretty much all the R's. Well, yes, all the R's are made by me. We also have my, come on, pop up, my Bitty's Hype. We also have from my tier 1, my Spirus B Raid. It has a little raid sort on with a little Bumblebee, which is actually supposed to be Sparks. And my tier 2 has my Applelet, which is my little face bang character. And she's dressed in a little hoodie. That's cute and orange. Little orange pants, little black booties. Nice cute brown gloves. She has Hype and GG on her because she's supposed to be like a lit emote. Also has a lyre and apple for that reason too. And my tier 3... is my GG turn from Team Fortress 2, from Blue Team, pretty much. So yeah, if you guys want any of these emotes, then sub that tier or that person, and you guys can get it. I hope... I hope you guys have an awesome day, an awesome night as well. If you guys still want to talk to me, you can talk to me during reruns, but of course, I won't answer you on the video, but I will answer you through, you know, through the chat still, so you guys can still talk to me and all. I hope you guys have an awesome day. I'll for sure be streaming tomorrow. I will be for sure streaming tomorrow because I like streaming. And we'll see if I continue with this or we do a different game and do Ace more. We'll just see. And yes, I will be playing my reruns after this. And this will be one of the reruns. So I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your day. And if you guys can, enjoy the reruns as well. I'll be seeing you guys next time. See you later, guys. Bye, guys.